Hello, everybody. Thanks for tuning into my predictions channel. This video is very interesting and special because instead of showing my face in the introduction like in so many videos past, I'm actually going to take the time to show a little more in-depth look at how these predictions are made. This time, looking at the dates themselves, how natural disaster dates are found. I have changed the style of the predictions a little bit, and I hope you guys will like it. So here comes the new way, and I'll start off with this. Check this out. So it is actually August the 23rd at the time of this video's production, and what you're about to see here is actually a chart that I've made myself showing the future, showing today's date, actually from the 21st of August all the way through the very end of September. Some of you that have heard my predictions before might actually remember me mentioning Chinese astrology and numerology as being some of the factors that I've used to try to find out when things could happen. And that's the truth. It's actually astronumerology that can pinpoint when these disasters can strike. Science alone can more or less expect certain natural disasters up to a week's time, in particular when it comes to meteorology. They can predict hurricanes up to 7 days in advance, more or less. Earthquakes are almost unpredictable, however. But this tactic might at least help us know when they're more likely to happen. These practices that have been around for thousands of years, literally thousands of years, you know, they have a long file of just wisdom, really. And you can tap into that wisdom just by learning these things. So the product of this is this chart that is now here before you. And it's what I would like to call a natural disaster risk indicator chart. And the indicators are actually the different astrology and numerology methods that I find very useful. There's a lot of these things out there. There's other predictors or people that experiment making predictions that use planetary astrology, for example, things like that. My side of things is more just old school Chinese astrology and numerology and a touch of Western astrology. And what this chart shows is how these indicators vary from day to day. And you can see there's a point scale from 1 to 10 on this. And mainly Chinese astrology and numerology can fluctuate up and down. The higher the number on the line for each indicator, that indicates that there's a higher risk according to that practice. So as you can see, the first peak risk day coming up, which is August the 25th, both numerology and Chinese astrology rank fairly high on the indicator chart, scoring close to the 5 and the 3. So when you take those and add them together, that's how you end up with an indicator level of 9. The Western astrology indicator is basically a flat line that hovers around the 1 point and then dips to 0 when its season is over, because there's like a slight season of disasters that comes and goes as the year turns. It's true, certain parts of the months are a little more favorable for natural disaster than others, but very slightly. That's why it only gets 1 point. Chinese astrology and numerology, however, they can give up to 5 points each. So under this system, any day of the year in a given year, if it has the right conditions, can be a risk date. And as you can see, from August 21st to the 31st, there's a fairly active period that we're entering right now, and it wanes into the 29th, 25th being the main risk day to watch. Now, here comes September. Look at September, and you will notice, yes, it's more bunched up because now we have 30 days on this chart versus just 10. But you see the pattern. There's ups and downs. One thing I haven't mentioned up to the point is the gray line that sits at level 6 on my chart. So if you go up from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 up to 6, you'll see this gray straight horizontal line going through. That line is actually the cutoff line. It's a cutoff line because it basically is there to show that anything below that number is not a risk date. Anything above that number is a risk date. And you see the varying categories from low to, you know, to high and very high. That's what this is. So out of all those lines on the chart, the one that really matters is the total risk line, which is the orange-yellow line. That's the indicator line for the date once we take into consideration astrology and numerology. If both astrology and numerology say the day is risky, it's going to get a high number on that chart. If numerology and astrology do not agree and one says yes, one says no to disaster risk, it brings the total risk down to something in the level 6 or 7 category. If risk is very low on both ends of the spectrum, it goes below 6 as a total, and therefore is considered a calm date. So this is how the big picture looks when you use numerology and astrology. Now, you can see here there's different periods. September 3rd through the 9th looks pretty strong. The same goes with September 12th through the 19th and September 26th through the 28th. Those would be the main risk periods in September. So a couple other little risk dates like the 21st to the 23rd of September and September 30th on there, but they have a lower risk and therefore lower chances of having something severe as well. Well, guys, this is my chart. I hope you guys liked it. Now, if you're wondering how I came up with this chart and how I came up with ranking the different numerology and Chinese astrology aspects, it's simply simple that I took a scale from 1 to 5 and assigned each a 1 to a 5, depending on whether they were low or high in the disaster risk, you know, category. And 3 would be something in the middle. So let's say both are a 3, that's how you end up with a 6. So basically, a date that scores less than 6 in total risk would be considered a fairly normal date. Chinese astrology is extremely complex. I suggest visiting a website called ChineseFortuneCalendar.com, and it has a plethora of information on Chinese astrology. And of course, it's guided more towards popular topics that have nothing to do with natural disasters, but instead simply like personal fortune and romance. But these same characteristics also affect time itself and the year and the world. So there's elements in Chinese astrology, and there is animal signs that exist for the day, the month, and the year. And the way that these three interact with each other, according to this astrology, indicates what kind of day we're dealing with. The days that have no harmony at all, but instead have animal signs conflicting with each other and elements also conflicting with each other, this indicates a risky day, while the opposite would indicate a calm day, a day where everything is in nice harmony. In numerology, it's basically just what kind of numbers exist in a certain day's numerology chart. And that would take a long time to explain as well. So this is as much as I can provide right now in this video. I hope you like the charts, and I hope you like the little of these visuals to help you guys see how the dates are come up with. So now, in the usual but not so usual form at the same time, I will present more or less the predictions for the coming 6 weeks. So here they come, and I hope you guys like the new style. right, my friends. Those were my predictions for late August through September 2019. I hope you guys liked the new style. Please let me know if the style really works out or if you still preferred my old way. I will show myself again in future videos, in case you're wondering. This time I just had to show these extra features, which I will keep showing from time to time. Well, I'll see you guys again for October and November 2019. Take good care.